As the president and Congress stage a fierce battle over legislation that could allow families of 9/11 victims to take legal action against Saudi Arabia, the Supreme Court has upheld a judgment awarding nearly $2 billion to families of those killed by Iranian-sponsored terrorism. Chief Legal Correspondent Shannon Bream is here to tell us what that means. Hi, Shannon.
Well, Brett, it's time for Iran to pay up. That's the bottom line of today's 6-2 opinion from the U.S. Supreme Court. For decades, the victims and families of terror attacks linked to Iran, including the 1983 Beirut bombings that killed 241 American service members, have been fighting to collect damages. After it was discovered Iran's central bank had assets in New York City, Congress passed a law making it easier for the victims to collect those funds. Iran's central bank countered that the legislative branch had no right to get involved in judicial matters. Well, today, in an opinion authored by Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, the court said this, quote, "By altering the law governing the attachment of particular property belonging to Iran, Congress acted comfortably within the political branch's authority over foreign sovereign immunity and foreign state assets."
This is the leading state sponsor of terrorism who has denied compensation to these victims for years. At the same time that it's going to be receiving over $100 billion in oil money returned as part of the Iran nuclear agreement.
In his dissent, which Justice Sotomayor joined, Chief Justice John Roberts wrote, quote, "No less than if it had passed a law saying respondents win. Congress has decided this case by enacting a bespoke statute tailored to this case that resolves the party's specific legal disputes to guarantee respondents victory. The terror attacks in this case were committed on foreign soil. Current law makes it difficult for Americans to sue for terrorist attacks they allege are committed by foreign states on U.S. soil. That has led to this debate over legislation that would enable 9/11 victims and their families to sue Saudi Arabia based on links those parties say show a direct tie between the 9/11 attacks and Saudi officials."